art element line is a fun one to play with or think about. A landscape picture is full of lines, but each line is of a different type. For instance, the horizon line I see isn't actually a line, and I can't get closer to it. The clouds have contour lines, but are non-solid objects. Just as the light and dark color of the water next to the sunlight in the middle is constantly moving and created by the shadows of the waves. Hi there, my name is Albert van der Zwart. Welcome to Imperfect Paintings, inspiring you to embrace the magic of making art. I see lines everywhere around me. Here I paint a roundish spot on the paper. The opaque spot has a contour line. But when I put a rock on the table, it creates a shadow next to it. When I turn the rock around, the shadow line isn't as solid as the rock. Still, I add an idea of a shadow with a different color. When dry, I cut it in 5 pieces and suddenly the space between them, the edges of the paper I work on, create lines as well. I can deliberately make lines or they appear when doing something else. Now I move one of the pieces and I mess up the original design. Or I can rearrange them like this. In real life I see random lines as well, like here after slicing my cheese. A fat cheese residue is left on the bottom of the slicer. Or here at my day job, some wet spots left behind by the cleaning machine. Opening up to lines can give you inspiration at any moment. 4 weeks ago I uploaded a video invite for this painting challenge, link up here. Thanks in case you participated. I showed how I took these sunset pictures to create this soft pastel version. The real challenge was a dare to make an ugly painting or version of the same scene. So I created a hideous color version and another one that, after looking at it for a while, I even started to like. Hartmut took up the challenge and noticed all the lines when playing Scrabble on her Kindle device. She created an abstracted version of it on paper, using black ink, white correction tape and a white pen. She also made this one, and the disarray of shapes and colors made her feel uneasy with it. She noticed that tension can be palpable when painting. In the video invite I showed this line painting, but it can just as easy be made using oil pastels. And I make a second one. Again I take the paper cutter and cut the paper into strips and start weaving them together. It doesn't become a great artwork, but it does make an interesting starting point to continue. Oh, and did you notice I made an error here? I forgot one under over. Adding liquid watercolor spots by using a piece of scrub swatch changes the scene. Another option is to follow a line and add a dark accent using an adding marker. Any idea is okay. Get one yourself, don't hesitate to try. Like Otmar thought of using a street map. He took the map of the village he lives and created a line drawing, mentioning it all took way more time than expected, although it was fun to add color in the next stage. He enjoyed looking for recognizable shapes and saw a bull. I noticed the blue-toothed monster. A week later, he even took up the challenge to create a sketchy, sloppy version, a real challenge for him, but he still enjoyed making it. When cycling through my hometown in the Netherlands, I almost daily see this new artwork in front of a new apartment building. Every time it makes me happy. What I see is a cutout of the shape of a tree next to real trees. But the artwork doesn't show the cutout of the tree, but only the leftovers of the cutout. It makes me think of the meaning of this artwork. Let's see if I can make my version using 2 pieces of sturdy 300 grams paper. I paint 2 massive lines on it and make a second one, almost identical. While waiting for them to dry, I make a test cutout of some leftover pieces of paper. And as often happens, I notice I possibly made a mistake. This may not work at all. So, what will? I make a fold at 1/3 of the test paper ones and put them in several ways next to each other to see if it will look interesting. Time and time again, I notice that I can see more when I look again or observe in more detail. Whatever I create, the next day I usually notice new elements or get ideas how to proceed or how I can try a new approach. Do I like what I made? Can I do it differently? Will darker be more interesting or is it better to use lighter colors? I question myself, but try not to judge. Now over to the real ones, and see what I can make of it. I do love to see art in public places. We have quite a collection in my hometown. Maybe it's interesting to cycle around and make a video of them on their location. Does it sound interesting? Let me know in the comments down below. Connie had this winter window picture with snow on the screen and made this quick one in black and white pastels. And another one using green and red for the snow to bring Christmas and Christmas colors. As a playful line exercise, she just drew some lines. She stopped when noticing she was already seeing several recognizable shapes in it. In between, while painting the house, she also found time to make these swirly lines. And sitting in her paint room, she noticed her mood board and created yet another line painting. Inspiration is never far away. I take a line painting from the video invite to play with. I put some strips of paper over it and take half of them away. I add a new strip and move it up and down. What I create is a series of passepartouts next to each other to block parts of the total painting. By doing so, I can easily change an aspect without being distracted by the whole image. Adding another color can be a simple change of the original. I love it. Simple and effective. Liz took this picture of one of her favorite trees. She really likes the deep, dramatic lines in the tree's bark. She usually uses watercolor, but as a challenge, this time she made an abstractish, loose charcoal version of the lines in the bark. And then she did the opposite and made a tight gold zentangle, also very loosely based on the look of the tree bark. Here a picture of a nearby lake in my hometown. It all looks 3D, like it's supposed to. Now over to a different weather condition, and the fog almost created a surreal 2D version of the same landscape. I always love autumn for the foggy views like this. And again, wherever you go, lines and inspiration are never far away. In case you would like to try to look at the landscape in a new way, just click on the link and I will see you over there in the next video. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful day.